Gumbo Rumble and face painters and jugglers for the kids and crawfish racing and you name it. So if you're into that food from the New Orleans area and you can't necessarily make it to New Orleans, well, they're bringing New Orleans to you. For more information, you go to their website, Craw Debauchery, that's CrawDebauchery.com. And you can also look up Craw Debauchery. They have a Facebook page, so you can get all the information that way as well. Here is an event from the other side of Florida, the other coast. I don't get over there that often, but it caught my eye because it's a holiday event, and it just looked like a lot of fun. It's taking place at the Clearwater Marine Aquarium from now through January 6th. It's their Winter's Wonderland, and their theme, first of all, it's the home to Winter and Hope, which are the rescued dolphins that were featured in Dolphin Tale and Dolphin Tale 2. And there's other rescued marine life there. And like many aquariums, they specialize in rehabilitating sea life that have fallen on hard times, have gotten sick or whatnot. They try and rehabilitate them so they can be released into the wild. But if it's too late to do that, then they will still rehabilitate them and keep them there. They have their own working marine animal hospital on site. So obviously all the visitors that come and pay their admission, it goes towards a great cause of helping to rehabilitate these animals. They've got all sorts of kids events going on there. Santa and his elves will be there as well. They've got a Sea of Lights boat cruise, which starts on November 16th. And all of this is happening, like I said, through January 6th at the Clearwater Marine Aquarium. All right, what else do we have for you? How about a little bit of airline news? First of all, maybe I should just have a brief rundown on my trip, which I forgot. Just back from Vegas this week, my home away from home. I'm usually out there 5-6 times a year on business. Some people don't believe that. But this time I was scheduled. I was actually working a convention at the Rio. Did not want to stay at the Rio. I prefer to stay on the Strip. I had a room booked at Cosmopolitan for $160 a night, plus about $40 in resort fees and exorbitant amounts of taxes, which is actually a good price for the Cosmopolitan. But since I recently stayed at the Mirage, they sent me an email offering me a rate of $69, plus, the resort fee, plus the tax, but with a $75 food and beverage credit. I was only staying there two nights, so it was a no-brainer. I moved over to the Mirage. It's not my favorite, but one of my favorites. I do like staying there. They got a great rock and roll vibe there. Some good places to eat. Some are very expensive and very fancy. I stayed away from those because I only had a $75 food and beverage credit, which doesn't go too far in Las Vegas. But I did have a great meal at the California Pizza Kitchen, which is right next to the sports book there at the Mirage, and another great meal at the Carnegie Deli, which is also right by the sports book, where the Carnegie Deli in New York no longer exists, so that is the Carnegie Deli, I suppose, now. It may be the only one, as far as I know of, and the sandwiches are the size of my head, not my mouth. So if you're hungry, great place to go. Also, I always talk about Lotus of Siam, my favorite Thai restaurant in Las Vegas. It's my favorite one probably in the world. I chose to go to my second favorite Thai restaurant this time. I haven't gone there in a couple of years, and I was glad that I made the switch just to try something different to kind of change it up a little bit. This place is called Weera Thai, or Thai, Weera Thai, W-E-E-R-A. It's on Sahara Avenue. My favorite dish there is the soft-shell crab, which is amazing, reasonably priced. It was, I think, $26. For a huge portion, that was all that I needed. It comes with green beans and some carrots and cucumbers and rice. It was a meal unto itself. That was all I needed, and that was like the most expensive thing on the menu. They also have a happy hour, which unusually runs from 5 to 10 p.m. With drink specials that run about $5, $6, appetizers and other small dishes that are like between $5 and $7. So if you don't have a hankering for the soft shell crab, you can eat there on the cheap and still get a really great meal. So Weera Thai, if you're in Las Vegas. Also, I flew Southwest out, JetBlue back, like I typically do. Both of them were on time. Both of them did a great job, so I appreciate that. Not everybody is always as happy as me, though. with any airline. And you know me, I report the news, you know, I call them as they come in. Here is a gentleman by the name of Emmanuel Borowski, and he boarded a flight from Manchester Regional Airport going to Baltimore, and he was carrying his $80,000 instrument with him, which was a violin. And he got on the plane late towards the end, and the overheads were all full, and they were going to force him to check his $80,000 violin. When he refused, they basically threw him off the flight. So he ended up missing some meetings that he needed. He had to do a presentation at the University of Maryland. He was teaching at Towson University. He missed all of that. He's a very accomplished musician. He's played in over 37 countries, is a loyal Southwest customer. He was extremely disappointed, according to Southwest, and I guess I understand their position, that the folks that boarded early have the first rights to the overhead bins, and he was late, and if, you know, they weren't going to throw out somebody else's suitcase because of him. So I understand that, but I also understand him not trusting his $80,000 violin to go with the rest of the luggage. So hopefully Southwest will make it up to him. I know that he is a loyal customer, so we'll see what happens. This isn't the first time that an airline has done this. American Airlines not too long ago told a woman that her $30,000 cello was too big for the seat that she purchased. She bought a seat for the cello and wasn't allowed to put it on either. So these things happen from time to time. I say I had great flights on both Southwest and JetBlue like I usually do. The airport, on the other hand, Fort Lauderdale Airport, I have to say it does not compare to PBI. I got off my plane. It was the red eye. So it was around 5 o'clock in the morning. Of course, I hadn't slept. The gentleman next to me was a larger fellow, and I was really cramped in my seat and just not that comfortable, and couldn't sleep. So I would have loved to have gotten home as quickly as possible. It took about 40 minutes for the suitcases to begin appearing at the baggage carousel. They never made an announcement as to which carousel it was going to be. The last time I flew into PBI, I was one of the first people off the plane. By the time I got to the luggage carousel, every single suitcase from the plane was already there. Grabbed my bag and walked out. That's good service. FLL, not so much. But a new survey just came out from the points guy, who runs a website where obviously he advises people about how to get the most out of their frequent flyer points. He ranked the nation's 30 busiest airports. The worst ones of all were all of the New York metro area airports. Of course, no surprise there, with JFK being the absolute worst. Pardon me, I fly there quite often. I'm not surprised. Orlando was ranked towards the bottom, 24th out of 30. I'm a little bit surprised for a very large and busy airport. I feel that they do a decent job, maybe not a phenomenal job, but a decent job. Miami came in number 12 out of 30. Fort Lauderdale, 26 out of 30. Fort Lauderdale is not a good airport. They happen to have some cheaper flights, sometimes direct flights, but when it comes to customer service at that airport, not good. If anybody from Fort Lauderdale Airport is listening, clean up your act, please. Speaking of that, flight delays are never good, and here's an airline I've never flown, British Airways, that this past week they had what was called a flight from hell. 3 days to go from Orlando to London, two full days stuck in two different airports. It was mechanical issues grounded the plane in Florida first for 24 hours, and then it didn't get very far, dumping fuel midair, lowering the landing gear at high altitude, and then being diverted to JFK, where they were stuck there overnight. So one flight, two overnight strandings. The passengers, the 200 passengers or so, not very happy with British Airways. I don't know what to say. I'll keep that in mind. I am going to try and get to Europe perhaps next spring, and if I have an option to not go with British Airways based on that, I might do that. Here's a different kind of a story. Philippine Airlines, a flight attendant, Patricia Oregano, she was busy doing her job. She recently had a child, and I guess she got back to work. And there was a mother who had a baby on the flight, and the baby was crying just ferociously. And, she went to the mother and just checked on the mother to make sure that the baby was okay. And the mother said that the baby was hungry and she had run out of formula for the baby. Well, of course, they don't carry baby formula on an airplane typically. And being that the flight attendant was still nursing her baby, she offered to nurse the baby for the mother. She did that. The baby fell asleep. The mother was thrilled and grateful. And all I could say is that really is going above and beyond for a flight attendant. And kudos to Patricia Oregano and Philippine Airlines for truly doing, more than what was called for. I mean, I'm hungry sometimes on a flight. Nobody's ever offered that for me. So I don't know, just saying. But not that I'm expecting that either. But in any event, it's always nice to hear when an airline is doing the right thing. This week, I think it was just yesterday, Royal Caribbean's Symphony of the Seas, which is now the largest cruise ship in the world, made its U.S. debut up, of all places, in Port Canaveral yesterday. It arrived there. 6,680 passengers fit on this cruise line. I know some people really like these large ships, especially when they're brand new. They've got all the bells and whistles, but I think that's too many people. I'd prefer something a little bit smaller than that. Let's see. I got a couple more travel stories. I think what I'm going to do is hold them for after the break, and then I got a couple of deals for you as well. So what you're going to want to do is stay tuned, and we will be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
I'm not smart enough. My resume's not up to date. They'll never pick someone like me. No one's hiring right now. Sound familiar? Don't let you get in the way of landing your next job opportunity. Sometimes it's best to leave it up to the experts. Did you know that the last reported job openings in the U.S. as of this recording was a series high of 6.7 million jobs, and that 1.1 million of those jobs were left unfilled? This means that there's a potential opportunity that's just right for you, and at Labor Finders, we're committed to helping you find it. Whether you're entering the workforce or looking for supplemental income in a job that starts right away, we've got you covered. With over 300,000 clients across the U.S. and 20,000 active daily workers, we have the network and the experience to get you your next job. Contact one of our nearly 200 offices today to see how we can help in your job search. Simply visit us online at www.laborfinders.com or connect with us on social media by searching the username LaborFinders.
And we are back. And as promised, I got another story or two on travel for you. And then we got some deals, both near and far, that you probably want to listen to. Because I know I called these for you, so they obviously have something going on. We were talking about the airlines. And the airline industry is extremely competitive. There are some airlines that are doing really well and other ones not so much that are in trouble. And it recently was announced that Iceland Air intends to acquire its chief rival, also based out of Iceland, which is WOW. And I'm not just saying WOW, it's WOW Air. The ultra-low-priced carrier, they're famous for having flights as cheap as sometimes $55 one way from the U.S. to Europe. Of course, everything is a la carte, so if you want to have oxygen, you got to pay extra for that. But in any event, the two of them were competing against each other, and while between the two they had a decent amount of the Iceland market, compared to the other airlines that fly over to Europe, they still only had combined less than 4% of the share of the transatlantic travel market. So by combining efforts and getting together, they can compete against the bigger carriers a little bit better. So we'll see if that gets approved by the regulators and whatnot, shareholders, etc. Here's an interesting story that I saw. There's an airline called Vietjet, which obviously is based out of Vietnam. And it seems that they had a huge success in the past by randomly having girls clad in bikinis appear on their flights. And it seems that they're not going to stop. I guess the customers love it. It seems to be a good strategy that's working for them, and they're not going to stop anytime soon. So I would like to get to Vietnam sometime soon. I don't know exactly where else they fly to, but they are buying a whole bunch of new jets. They're investing $6.5 billion on new jets and making sure that they've got some beautiful girls in bikinis to ride on them as well. And sign me up, please. Thank you. All right, with that, we've got some Dan's deals for you. As I always like to say, I try to do these geographically, starting with what's closest to home and working my way further and further away. This is not an exact science, and I am not a geography major, so if I'm a little bit off, I apologize now. The first deal I have is a town that I really enjoy going to. I prefer to not be in the dead of summer because it can be a little hot and humid there. It also can be a little bit pricey depending upon the time of year, but I found this deal on Travelzoo for a beautiful, high-end, top-of-the-line hotel in Charleston's historic district, which is a great place to go, wonderful sights to see, excellent foodie town. Just the restaurants there are incredible, but hotels can set you back quite a bit, but here you can stay in one of the top hotels. I mean, this is like named number 9 in the U.S. and number 1 in Charleston by Travel and Leisure in 2017. I'm talking about, you know, like 5-star caliber hotel. As little as $169 a night, Sundays through Thursdays from November 15th to March 5th, so you don't have to worry about the heat and humidity. That's for a signature queen room. You can upgrade your room. Those are on sale, too. And this includes a $25 credit every day at their restaurant there in the hotel, the Revival Restaurant. Self-parking is only $17. Valet is only $25, which is not bad for a fancy hotel. It is not pen-friendly, so only if you have a service animal are they invited. Free Wi-Fi is included. There's no resort fee, which is unusual this time these days. So check that out on Travelzoo, but it you got to book it by November 30th, so you actually have a tiny bit of time. Here is a deal to a place that can be very, very expensive. This vacation package, which includes air, is less than many people pay just for air alone. Also found on Travelzoo, the vendor on Travelzoo is a tour operator called Cox and Kings, and this is a trip to India. Cox and Kings has actually escorted travelers to India since 1758. Hopefully they have it, you know, down by now, but in any event, departing from New York, you're going to have to get yourself to New York, April, May, and June dates, as little as $13.99 per person, and we're talking about New Delhi, Agra, and Jaipur, so three different cities, 4- and 5-star hotels for a total of 8 nights, airfare from the U.S. to India, hotels, sightseeing, transfers on an air-conditioned vehicle, English-speaking guide, daily breakfast, 2 lunches, 3 dinners, all starting at $13.99. Like I say, just to fly there in the past could have cost you that much. Now you get the airfare, you get everything. There's all sorts of customizing and upgrading that you can do. You got to book this by November 21st. Visit Travelzoo to see that. Another website that I talk about often for just airfare is Scott's Cheap Flights, and in the past day or two, I found these deals. Keep in mind that they don't guarantee that they'll be around for more than a couple of days, although sometimes they are, but there's always new deals at Scott's Cheap Flights. You can visit them at scottscheapflights.com, sign up for their free email service, and they'll give you these deals on a daily basis. For about $40 a year, you can get even better deals, which are pretty good. This is a deal to Italy, and you can fly between November and March to Bologna from Miami for as little as $481 round trip, which is a pretty good deal. There are, let's see, I'll just look for ones that leave from Florida. You can go to Rome from Miami for $463, and that's nonstop direct, which is not easy to do to anywhere overseas from Florida. I mean, unless the Caribbean or South America, perhaps. So anyway, those are some great deals to Italy, and who doesn't love Italy? I know I do. Also found on Scott's Cheap Flights, here are some deals to Asia, and it's all over Asia. These you're going to have to leave from either JFK in New York or LAX in Los Angeles, but from New York, let's see, there are deals to Thailand, to Vietnam, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, Manila in the Philippines, and they range from as little as $425 round trip to just over $500 or so. Round trip, you know, all the way to Asia, that is some pretty good prices. So you may want to go check that out at scottscheapflights.com. But hurry, because these are typically only good for a couple of days. This one message here, they said that if you're a paid subscriber, they had round-trip airfare to Copenhagen for as little as $343. So if you're truly interested in going overseas, you might want to, you know, sign up for the paid e-newsletters from Scott's Cheap Flights. This last deal that I have for you for tonight, I found on Travelzoo. And again, it's to Asia, but for those of you who would prefer to do a cruise in Asia, we got this one here for you. So it's on Holland America via Prestige Cruises, found on Travelzoo. And you got to book this by November 21st. It is 14 nights Asia cruise in a balcony cabin. I always say that if I'm ever looking for a deal, if it's not a balcony, count my wife out. She will not do an inside cabin on a cruise. It's just too small for her, too claustrophobic. This includes your round-trip flights as well. From 18 different gateways, so you probably can find one here in Florida. Let's see. All your gratuities are paid for as part of this, which is a $406 value per cabin. All the taxes and fees are included in this, and it's as little as $22.99. That's less than $165 per day per person, and that one departs a round trip out of Shanghai on February 17th, visiting China, Korea, and Japan. For $100 more, you can go from Tokyo to Vancouver or reverse for either 15 or 13 nights. Another $100 more, so now we're up to about $2,500. You can cruise from Hong Kong to Shanghai with stops in Taiwan and Japan on February 2nd. Also for $25.99, Taiwan and Japan from Shanghai to Hong Kong on March 3rd. And for $25.99, you can do East Asia from Singapore to Hong Kong, departing on November 23rd. Or December 7th for 14 nights. These are some great deals for a balcony cabin. Asia is just a great place to go to. And, of course, remember, when you're on a cruise, you know, you got all your meals taken care of. You got entertainment taken care of. That's a pretty good deal. All right, I wanted to remind everybody that Facebook.com/ The Golf and Travel Show. Go and like our page, and you will be notified of who we've got coming up next. Next week, I will be in the air on my way to Phoenix. So a previously recorded show will be played. The week after that, we're going to be welcoming back Rich Limpert. He is, of course, our tech gadget guy, also golf writer and tennis writer. And that's going to be Black Friday, so he's going to have some holiday gift-giving ideas for all of you on Black Friday. And then the following week, we're going to welcome back Barney Adams, of course, the legendary Tight Lies inventor. We're going to be talking once again about the new shaft that he has invented, and we're going to be giving away a couple of Barney's $200 putter shafts, so you're not going to want to miss it. Tune in every week, same time, same place, to the Golf and Travel Show. And every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. Homeward bound, out of showers, homeward bound. When my thoughts are skating home, when my music's playing home, when my love lies waiting silently for me.
You have been listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu, heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 a.m. WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit 'em straight.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Me and my old lady ain't been getting along.